Tonight on NewsWatch, Israel on alert. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu plans a military response to yesterday's deadly bombing in Jerusalem.
Plus, next to fall, Syria's president reportedly resorts to violence to keep control of his country.
And starting early, the election is more than 18 months away, but Republicans are already fighting for your vote. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. The city of Jerusalem is on a high alert today. Good evening, I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. It's a reaction to yesterday's deadly bombing. Now the Israel government is looking at ways to retaliate. CBN Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell has tonight's top story.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu pledged Israel would act vigorously, responsibly, and prudently, preserve the quiet and security that existed here the last 2 years. Netanyahu spoke after an explosive device packed with shrapnel went off near a busy Jerusalem city bus stop, killing one woman and wounding more than 40 others. CBN News has learned that the woman killed in the terror attack was a Christian who had been working for more than 15 years translating the Bible into the language of a tribe in Togo. Mary Gardner was Scottish, and she came to Israel at the beginning of the year to study at the Hebrew University's Rothberg International School. Gardner was killed almost instantly in the terror attack. This is the kiosk where Wednesday's bombing took place. Ironically, in Hebrew, it's called the blast of a kiosk because a bomb exploded here in 1994. Yesterday, the man running the kiosk saw a suspicious package under this public phone booth when the bomb exploded.
I went closer to see what happened. And I saw this phone booth on fire and people here on the ground. I don't know. Scary.
Many Jerusalemites felt they were catapulted back a number of years when terrorist bombings rocked the city on a regular basis.
I very much hope we won't return to those terrible years. I hope the government will do what it needs to do to give people security.
Netanyahu met with Defense Minister Ehud Barak and other top security officials just before leaving on a pre-planned trip to Russia. According to reports, they drew up what is widely expected to be a considerable military response. Police spokesman Mickey Rosenfeld said the search for the terrorist is continuing.
Since yesterday's attack, we've heightened security in Jerusalem, as well as in the southern part of Israel, in order to prevent any further attacks from taking place.
Palestinian Authority leaders were quick to condemn the attack. No group has claimed responsibility, but Islamic Jihad vowed earlier this week to avenge a series of Israeli airstrikes in Gaza, mounted in response to stepped-up rocket and mortar fire on Israeli communities. Overnight, Israel targeted a smuggling tunnel and terror activity site in Gaza. Since the weekend, more than 25 rockets and mortars have hit Israel, including 4 Grad rockets, which hit major cities. In the meantime, for the people of Jerusalem, life is beginning to return to normal, even at the scene of Israel's latest terror attack. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Libyan dictator Muammar Gaddafi tested the no-fly zone today, and it turned out to be a suicide mission for the pilot. French fighter jet shot down what turned out to be a Libyan training jet as it landed at Misrata. It was the first Libyan aircraft to challenge the UN restrictions. Coalition bombers continued to strike at Gaddafi positions, including tanks, an ammunition bunker, and a small number of helicopters sitting on an airfield. So far, the no-fly zone, though, has proved effective over Libya, but it is taking a lot of work. CBN News' Chuck Holton is in Italy, where some of the American forces are stationed.
American aircraft continue to come and go from the Naval Air Station here at Sigonella in support of Operation Odyssey Dawn. But as pressure mounts in Washington for the Obama administration to find a way out of the conflict and minimize costs to the taxpayers, the military personnel here are going to continue to support their brothers in arms in the skies over Libya.
Lieutenant Matt Knight is the base public affairs officer.
And Naval Air Station Sigonella is a logistics base. It's our historical mission is to support 6th Fleet, NATO, and combatant commanders. In this operation, that support has just become greater. However, it's still our normal mission. It's just the scale and the scope has increased. They were flying from here to Tunisia to Cairo, taking refugees out before this started. So we started as a humanitarian and then shifted into supporting ongoing operations mandated by the UN Resolution 1973.
Chuck Holton, CBN News at Sigonella Naval Air Station.
Protests that rocked the Arab world in recent weeks are now hitting Syria. Emergency laws in place for nearly 50 years ban all forms of demonstrations, but that hasn't stopped thousands of people from taking to the streets. A warning, some of the images in our next report are disturbing. George Thomas has more.
These are the images and sounds that Syrian President Bashar al-Assad doesn't want the world to see. Tens of thousands of protesters chanting freedom slogans. For nearly 40 years, Bashar al-Assad and his family has ruled the Syrian nation with an iron grip. Now the president is possibly facing a threat against his regime like never before.
This is the worst carnage in Syria since 1982, when Bashar al-Assad's father, Hafez al-Assad, killed 20,000 people to try and put down a Muslim Brotherhood uprising.
The southern city of Daraa is in the crosshairs of Syrian security forces.
The sound of live ammunition, security forces dispatched in full force.
The network Al Jazeera is reporting fierce battles between police and protesters. Then there's this disturbing video that has surfaced on YouTube, allegedly showing dead people on the streets of Daraa. Others can be seen lying on the ground bleeding. The Arabic channel Al Arabiya claims some 100 people have been killed in fighting between police and protesters. Daraa is symptomatic of many cities today across the Middle East. Poor, Islamic, too much unemployment, and too little freedom.
Syria is similar to what we saw in uprisings in Tunisia and Egypt, and Libya for that matter, in that the dictators, the Arab despots, are keeping huge sums of money for themselves, stowing it away in Swiss banks. And these young people who have a hard time finding jobs are moving to the towns away from the rural areas because they have no jobs and no opportunity.
Syrians are looking at a region that's unraveling before their eyes. From Algeria to Egypt, from Saudi Arabia to Yemen, waves of protest against autocratic dictators. Experts wonder if Syria will be the next Arab regime to fall. For now, though, all eyes are on Friday. A Facebook group called the Syria Revolution 2011 is calling for rallies at mosques across the country Friday on a day of dignity. George Thomas, CBN News.
Back here at home, former Massachusetts Governor Mitt Romney is proposing a new way to block the Democratic health care law. Romney writes in National Review Online, "If I were president, on day one, I would issue an executive order paving the way for Obamacare waivers to all 50 states. The executive order would direct the Secretary of Health and Human Services and all relevant federal officials to return the maximum possible authority to the states to innovate and design health care solutions that work best for them. Since an outright repeal would take time, an executive order is the first step in returning power to the states." Romney says a national system that raises taxes is not the best solution for America.
For the past decade, the casualties of war have overwhelmed America's Veterans Affairs hospitals and medical facilities. And to add fuel to that fire, a new survey of the nation's female veterans finds the VA's care for women is lacking. White House correspondent Jennifer Wishon explains.
More than 200,000 women have fought or are fighting in the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. And despite efforts to keep them out of direct ground combat, the enemy's use of guerrilla tactics routinely put women on the front lines. But a survey conducted by the American Legion found only a quarter of America's 1.8 million female vets take advantage of medical benefits available through Veterans Affairs.
Women who have been wounded, women who have lost limbs, women who suffer mentally and emotionally today because they chose to serve America.
The survey found one of the issues is privacy.
Many female veterans don't feel safe in the care environment for simple concerns such as privacy. So closing the door when the patient is in for exam Those are common sense things.
Other survey results, 25% say they're dissatisfied with the competence of VA health providers compared to private doctors. Nearly 40% are dissatisfied with the screening process for military sexual trauma, which is required for all vets receiving VA care. 38% say they wouldn't use a VA doctor for a second opinion, even if it was free. And the survey suggests there's lots of room for improvement to female-specific care.
Any primary care provider can do an annual pelvic exam, which is a really important exam. But do they do it? Are they comfortable doing it? Do the exam tables have stirrups? Those kind of things are VAs moving in that direction.
Command Sergeant Major Francis Rivera serves as a medical commander.
I'm living here with a lot of ideas.
And since surveys often collect dust in Washington, the American Legion is vowing to use it to make positive healthcare changes for the women who've served America with honor. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Washington.
Coming up, he's ready to return, even after he was put behind bars in Haiti. An American missionary vows to continue his work.
Attention investors, now is the time to protect your retirement accounts and investments.
Excessive government spending is devaluing the U.S. dollar and high rates of inflation are coming. Gold has tripled since 2001 and some experts predict the prices will climb another 100%. Buy gold now, direct and wholesale with United Gold Group. The demand for gold around the world is higher than ever. Foreign countries like China and India are buying up gold at record rates. Why? What do they know that you don't?
Call now and get your Gold Investors Kit absolutely free. Call in the next 5 minutes and receive The Secret to Owning Gold in Your Retirement Account, also absolutely free. Just call 1-800-758-5070. That's 1-800-758-5070.
This could be the most important call you make this year. United Gold Group, investing in America's future.
Do you take fish oil? There's an omega-3 supplement that's better than regular fish oil.
Staying healthy, it's not easy. I exercise regularly and eat lots of fruits and vegetables. I used to take a fish oil supplement too, but then I discovered something better than regular fish oil.
Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil. It's from the makers of One A Day, so I know I can trust it. The omega-3s in Arctic Wonder both support heart health and are scientifically proven to be better absorbed than regular fish oil. You'd have to take 6 of these fish oil soft gels to get the strength of just 2 Arctic Wonder soft gels.
The Arctic Wonder does not have an aftertaste.
They go down real easy.
Arctic Wonder isn't just good for your heart. It also supports healthy brain function and a healthy immune system.
This is one of the products that I plan to take for the rest of my life.
Arctic Wonder is from One A Day and not available in stores. For a special trial offer, call or go online now. Call 1-800-409-7339. That's 1-800-409-7339. Or go online to tryarcticwonder.com now.
Meteorologists believe it was a tornado that destroyed 30 homes and damaged 60 others yesterday in western Pennsylvania. No one was seriously injured, but the storm ripped off roofs and uprooted trees in Westmoreland County, just east of Pittsburgh. Wednesday's storm was part of a system that stretched from Nebraska to upstate New York. 9 states reported well over 300 incidents of severe weather.
Questions tonight about the safety of an airport used by many members of Congress. Late Tuesday night, 2 passenger jets had to land with the assistance of air traffic controllers. Pilots could not raise anyone in the airport's tower because the one person working had apparently fallen asleep. The FAA suspended the controller today. It also decided to make sure 2 air traffic controllers are in the tower from now on. Meanwhile, a massive fuel tank fire at Miami International Airport caused dozens of flights to be delayed. It took firefighters 2 hours to get it under control. No one was injured. The fire was not near any runways or terminals, fortunately, but it did reduce the airport's available fuel supply. One of the fuel tanks that exploded had the capacity to hold 1 million gallons of fuel.
Exodus International is defending its iPhone app that Apple pulled from its online store. Exodus is the Christian ministry that helps people struggling with homosexuality. Apple claims the app violates its guidelines by being too offensive. Jeff Buchanan, though, is with Exodus International and spoke with us earlier by Skype.
Well, we're, of course, disappointed with Apple's decision. We feel that it reflects a lack of diversity and tolerance on their iTunes platform, and we simply ask that we be fairly represented and that our message also be able to exist on the iTunes platform. Unfortunately, there are many groups that are out there. They're trying to silence our message, greatly misconstrue our message, greatly misrepresent who we are. For instance, we do not cure people. That is not in our methodology, nor is it our message. We are here to help people live lives that is congruent with their faith and that is inclusive of their sexuality.
And to see that entire interview with Exodus International, hear what other Christian ministries are being targeted by gay rights activists, go to our website, cbnnews.com. The American missionary who spent 5 months in a Haitian jail says he is grateful for his freedom.
But he's ready to return to help the people in that struggling nation. CBN News' Ephraim Graham traveled to Florida, where Pi spoke with him about his desire to return.
Bradenton, Florida is about 800 miles from Haiti, but a lifetime away from the Haitian jail cell in Jacmel, where missionary Danny Pi spent some 5 months locked up in a 10 by 12 foot cell with some 28 other inmates. To this day, he still has little clue as to why the judge sent him there and why he was locked up for so long. He is now here home in Bradenton, along with his wife and their newborn son. He arrived just 2 days before that baby was born, thanks to a little help from the American Center for Law and Justice. But though he's here and he's home and he's safe, he and his family are actually ready to head back to Haiti to be reunited with the orphans he and his wife have adopted.
We made a promise to 22 kids that we're going to be their mom and dad until they're through high school and ready to be adults. And we don't plan on breaking that promise. We never did. And we can't. I mean, they depend on us.
And Danny says his family will be ready to return to Haiti just as soon as baby Joseph has a passport. In Bradenton, Florida, Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Thanks, Ephraim. And Danny spoke with Ephraim at length about his confinement in that prison in Haiti. You don't want to miss that. You can see more of that interview on the 700 Club and right here on NewsWatch in the coming days.
Up next, a crowded field. Republicans line up for the chance to challenge the president in 2012.
Attention investors, now is the time to protect your retirement accounts and investments.
Excessive government spending is devaluing the U.S. dollar and high rates of inflation are coming. Gold has tripled since 2001 and some experts predict the prices will climb another 100%. Buy gold now, direct and wholesale with United Gold Group. The demand for gold around the world is higher than ever. Foreign countries like China and India are buying up gold at record rates. Why? What do they know that you don't?
Call now and get your gold investor's kit absolutely free. Call in the next 5 minutes and receive The Secret to Owning Gold in Your Retirement Account, also absolutely free. Just call 1-800-758-5070. That's 1-800-758-5070.
This could be the most important call you make this year. United Gold Group, investing in America's future.
Do you take fish oil? There's an omega-3 supplement that's better than regular fish oil.
Staying healthy, it's not easy. I exercise regularly and eat lots of fruits and vegetables. I used to take a fish oil supplement too, but then I discovered something better than regular fish oil.
Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil. It's from the makers of One A Day, so I know I can trust it. The omega-3s in Arctic Wonder both support heart health and are scientifically proven to be better absorbed than regular fish oil. You'd have to take 6 of these fish oil soft gels to get the strength of just 2 Arctic Wonder soft gels.
The Arctic Wonder does not have an aftertaste.
They go down real easy.
Arctic Wonder isn't just good for your heart. It also supports healthy brain function and a healthy immune system.
This is one of the products that I plan to take for the rest of my life.
Arctic Wonder is from Oneaday and not available in stores. For a special trial offer, call or go online now. Call 1-800-409-7339. That's 1-800-409-7339. Or go online to tryarcticwonder.com now.
Well, it's only March of 2011, but the 2012 presidential race is apparently underway, with potential candidates visiting key primary states.
And many of them are already competing directly for the all-important evangelical vote, especially in places like Iowa and South Carolina. David Brody explains in tonight's Focus Report.
Political rule number one in Iowa: if you want to win the presidential caucus, court the evangelicals.
We have people in Washington, D.C. who believe the unborn do not have a right to life. Yes, they do.
Five expected presidential contenders took their first opportunity to reach that audience at the recent Faith and Freedom Coalition event north of Des Moines, Iowa. They received a stark message.
My message to the National Republican Party tonight is real simple. If you turn your backs on the pro-family, pro-life constituency, and on the values that they stand for, you will be consigned to permanent minority status.
A long line of hopefuls is expected to compete for those votes. Tim Pawlenty, Rick Santorum, Newt Gingrich, Herman Cain, and Buddy Romer all showed up last week. And don't forget familiar faces like Mike Huckabee, Sarah Palin, and possibly even Michelle Bachmann.
When all is said and done, all of these candidates are going to come right here to Iowa. It is where many presidential dreams begin and end. And evangelicals play a crucial role in all of this, because what has to happen here is that all of these candidates have to prove their street cred with evangelicals, meeting, greeting, and talking about issues important to evangelicals.
Rick Santorum has an early lead in Iowa, well, at least in the number of visits. He hopes his record of being a strong defender of social issues will resonate here.
It's one thing to get up and give your social conservative speech and tell people, you know, what you believe in. It's another thing to go out and live it and lead it.
In Iowa, evangelicals typically make up about 60% of caucus goers. It's about the same number in the early primary state of South Carolina. That turnout could grow even more as the Tea Party comes back for round two on the national scene. In many ways, Christian conservatives and Tea Party activists strike similar chords, including their grassroots efforts at the beginning of an election season.
The people in this room are the ones who make the Iowa Faith and Freedom Coalition go.
And it's those volunteers and influential voters who presidential contenders want to reach.
I love you. I love what you stand for.
I want to listen to the people of Iowa.
America's in trouble.
If you want a European secular socialist, you have a great incumbent president.
We need to be a country that's turning towards God, not away from God.
Each one of these candidates make their case. Some, like Herman Cain, take the direct approach.
I'm a Baptist preacher.
Cain is a relative unknown, but he knows how to reach this audience.
When he first became president, and he went to Turkey to give a speech and declared that we were not a Christian nation, well, I got news for the president. We are a Judeo-Christian nation, and a lot of people want to keep it that way.
Newt Gingrich, on the other hand, is a familiar face. His three marriages might hurt his case with some voters, but Gingrich hopes his staunch defense of Judeo-Christian principles and his fight against radical Islam will outweigh other negatives.
Our Judeo-Christian civilization is under attack from two fronts. On one front, you have a secular atheist elitism, and on the other front, you have radical Islamists. And both groups would like to eliminate our civilization if they could, for different reasons, but with equal passion.
With so many candidates in the game, voters here in Iowa and around the country will have their hands full.
We have a lot of homework to do, and I want to make sure that my vote is informed and the right one.
They're all going to be good competitors, and we're lucky to have so many.
I was just really happy to see this many people of faith here at one time gathering for all the same thing, and it gives me a lot of hope for the future.
And it's no accident that audiences like this are getting together.
Nationally, we built a database of over 20 million evangelical voters.
Plus, the Faith and Freedom Coalition already has 400,000 members, with organizations in 24 states, including the key early primary states of Iowa, New Hampshire, South Carolina, and Florida.
We wanted to make sure that we could have an impact on choosing the next president. And if you want to do that, you can't wait until the general election. You got to get engaged early.
And engaged they are. From the moral issues of the rising debt to abortion and traditional marriage, evangelicals will have a major impact.
We're not going to be silent, we're not going to be intimidated, and we're not going to go away. We are here to stay, and we have earned our right to speak.
David Brody, CBN News, in the suburbs of Des Moines, Iowa.
Up next, a helping hand for a horse. We'll see what extreme measures some have taken to save the life of an abused animal.
Attention investors, now is the time to protect your retirement accounts and investments.
Excessive government spending is devaluing the U.S. dollar and high rates of inflation are coming. Gold has tripled since 2001 and some experts predict the prices will climb another 100%. Buy gold now, direct and wholesale with United Gold Group. The demand for gold around the world is higher than ever. Foreign countries like China and India are buying up gold at record rates. Why? What do they know that you don't?
Call now and get your Gold Investors Kit absolutely free. Call in the next 5 minutes and receive The Secret to Owning Gold in Your Retirement Account, also absolutely free. Just call 1-800-758-5070. That's 1-800-758-5070.
This could be the most important call you make this year. United Gold Group, investing in America's future.
Do you take fish oil? There's an omega-3 supplement that's better than regular fish oil.
Staying healthy, it's not easy. I exercise regularly and eat lots of fruits and vegetables. I used to take a fish oil supplement too, but then I discovered something better than regular fish oil.
Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil. It's from the makers of One A Day, so I know I can trust it. The omega-3s in Arctic Wonder both support heart health and are scientifically proven to be better absorbed than regular fish oil. You'd have to take 6 of these fish oil soft gels to get the strength of just 2 Arctic Wonder soft gels.
The Arctic Wonder does not have an aftertaste.
They go down real easy.
Arctic Wonder isn't just good for your heart. It also supports healthy brain function and a healthy immune system.
This is one of the products that I plan to take for the rest of my life.
Arctic Wonder is from One A Day and not available in stores. For a special trial offer, call or go online now. Call 1-800-409-7339. That's 1-800-409-7339. Or go online to tryarcticwonder.com now.
A miniature horse has a new lease on life thanks to a rescue group in Texas.
Midnight, the mini horse was taken from a neglectful owner and given to the rescue group, but a leg injury had workers worried that they would have to euthanize the horse. That is until a TV news story gave them hope.
We saw that they were building prosthetics for humans, and we thought, if it can be done for humans, could it be done for a horse? The first time we saw him run, it made us cry. We all cried. It's amazing that Midnight just now has the opportunity to just be a horse. You know, there's obviously no guarantees, but Midnight's only 4. And the hope is that he can live to be 25 or 30 and have a full life and just be happy and healthy.
Wow. Well, a company that makes artificial limbs for humans created the prosthetic for Midnight. Rescue workers were just hoping the mini horse would have a chance to walk again. But after the second fitting, check him out.
Yeah.
He took off running. I mean, running fast.
Can't tell any difference, can you?
Wow.
That's great.
That is so cool.
We have dear friends in North Florida, in Jacksonville, who do that same sort of thing on a much smaller scale. Mm. And she had a goat that was paralyzed in its hind legs.
Yeah.
And so he rigged up the kind of a skateboard thing, attached the goat to the skateboard, and
That's
the goat
amazing.
Was able to go around on that. Pretty amazing.
Yeah, I think that is really
cool.
And I think God is happy when that happens.
Yeah.
Well, that's all for this edition of NewsWatch.
Good night.